Hello, friends. Welcome to my Terry Joe is on the go series. Today, we are at Winterthur Museum, Garden, and Library, located in Winterthur, Delaware. This is the first of two visits that I'll be making to Winterthur. Today, I'm focused on the former home of Henry Francis DuPont, born in 1880 and died in 1969. Henry Francis H.F. DuPont assumed the role of estate manager after his mother died in 1902, and he began managing the estate's grounds in 1909. H.F. officially inherited Winterthur in 1927 after his father died at the end of 1926. In 1951, the home was the sixth largest private residence in the country. And in 1951, it went from being a private residence to a museum. Henry Francis took a 50-room house and tripled it to its present 175 rooms. Why so big? Because he was a collector. He started with birds' eggs and graduated to American Antiques. Outside In is an exhibition at Winterthur's Museum, Garden, and Library. As a child, Henry Francis DuPont was a collector. He gathered birds, eggs, plants, and other natural objects in the gardens and woods of Winterthur and beyond. In later years, that same drive to gather and create beauty with objects was translated on a grand scale into his remarkable collections of decorative arts. Outside In considers how DuPont's interiors look to the outside and brought it inside in an aesthetic that has inspired designers ever since. This cabinet was probably commissioned for Philadelphia Masonic Lodge and contains two tiers of section trays designed to hold objects of special meaning to the lodge members. Painted by Aaron Schickler in 1965, the photograph of Henry Francis DuPont in the Cottage Conservatory was taken by Donald Soltner Wells in 1964. On the other side of the wall is the East Terrace Garden. This is where the DuPonts used to entertain. This is the East Terrace Garden. It's a favorite spot for weddings. They had 50 weddings here last season. Almost every Friday and Saturday night at 6:30, the ceremonies would begin. Along the back wall, there's a speaker cabinet. It has big speakers in it. When there was a working farm on Winterthur's property, Henry loved to turn his opera music all the way up. He loved to fill the farm. He thought the cows were more productive when they were listening to opera. When Henry Francis DuPont expanded the house in the late 1920s, he resolved to preserve as many of the site's fine old tulips and American beeches as possible. Working with Marion Coffin, a landscape architect and close friend, he created a formal garden complete with stone balustrades and an elegant summer house. Today, the East Terrace provides a transition between the museum and the surrounding naturalistic garden.